We did the trends that fell off, but what about the trends that made it through the decade and became staples, or even became classic, or were already classics and were trends again? We got 10 of them from 2010 to 2019 that inspired a generation and fueled the future. I'm your boy Reggie Casual. That's next. Let's get it. The Chelsea boot. Oh, you thought I was gonna leave the Chelsea boot out? You might be asking, how can something make the fell off list and also make the decade list? Well, the Chelsea is the boot that introduced many in the West, particularly America, to the prospect of wearing boots outside of Tim's. The problem is that there were far too many who just wore them for the trend. But you can't deny that the Chelsea's played a hand in redefining street fashion into the more contemporary in the 2010s. So while already popular in Europe, street fashion adopted the Chelsea. And then it fell off, but those who loved it kept it. And that's okay. That being said, luxury street fashion killed the 2010s. Fear of God, Cold Wall, Off-White, Rude, Palm Angels, Heron Preston, Filing Pieces, Ready Made, and of course, Hood by Air that basically started it all, at least in the West, among others, of course. While Japan was on this back in 97 with the advent of Mastermind, it was so hard to get, it didn't generate mass appeal. But once the aforementioned brands hit the scene, luxury streetwear exploded, and it continues to see success today, not only in their own brands, but in major labels as well. The hoodie trench combo. How can we forget? It's a newbie that should have been a no-brainer years ago. It probably was in Europe, we just weren't paying attention. But it's a fantastic combo that adds layers without looking like you're trying too hard. Spearheaded by our friends in Europe, oversized to astronomical heights by our friends in Japan, and hitting its cultural stride by the time it gets to the US. The hoodie trench combo is a worldwide effort that we should all be proud of, no matter what continent you live in. Good job, street fashion fans. Speaking of oversize, its staying power has been a thing of surprise, but welcome. While in Japan, oversize is a staple that will never die due to the cuts Japanese designers naturally explore, out west it took a while for it to catch on, but when it did, we got a wave of style-heavy stalwarts that gave the West the push it needed to explore wider, boxier, longer, and adventurous silhouettes, and we are all better for it. You can't have the last two of the hoodie trench and oversize if we don't mention heavy layering. Layering became such a hit for guys in the 2010s that you literally have fashion heads screaming for fall and winter so they could layer up again. No joke, people were wishing for summer, summer of all seasons to end so they could look fresh again. And it continues today. The new season is fall winter so cats can maximize their wardrobe, and that's no surprise as people have become more savvy and their fashion aptitude has increased considerably. But it is probably high time we all learn how to keep it up in the warmer months. The resurgence of vintage, big trend. It started with band tees, it ended with all vintage. While band tees may have simmered down a bit, it did encourage people to go vintage shopping again. And this trend towards vintage was so powerful that it birthed new companies, essentially changed the market, and nearly killed retail, and is slowly killing fast fashion, which might be a good thing. But all that being said, vintage is king. No matter how you feel about the chunky sneaker era, the reality is that these were such a hit that they spearheaded a new era of shoe design altogether. One that merged street with designer. And we got some great releases from it. The Oswegos, the Kiwas, and yes, the Balenciaga Triple S's may have alienated a few, but were strong enough to make chunky, thick, and juicy sneakers a staple for a lot of fashion enthusiasts. Athleisure. Athleisure is the trend of the 2010s. Full stop. And it isn't nearly as ostentatious as the others, but it is the one that can suit nearly everyone. It was huge, it still is huge, and has ultimately changed the way that the big brands like Nike and Adidas, or if you're German, Adidas, approach their apparel divisions. And some like Puma and Lacoste taking risks that were worth it. And while Nike did give us Nike Lab ACG, Retro ACG, AAE, and Adidas gave us White Mountaineering Y3 and XBYO, which expanded the popularity of tech wear, nothing compares to the charge Onitsuka Tiger has made, putting athleisure at the forefront of its whole marketing campaign and making it less about strict athletics and making it more street-centric, but refined enough to hit the runway. We all know the story of dad hats. They have supplanted snapbacks as the official hat for everyday. Dad hats are so popular, nearly every brand makes them and are a direct result of things becoming even more casual than they already were. Dad hats also are easily accepted in nearly every style, making them a timeless essential that almost anybody can do. Even late bloomers like myself find them invaluable. And the number one trend that made the decade? Distressed denim. Yeah, that's right. It happened. Distressed denim just killed it. While early on, distressed denim struck a chord with OGs for being far, far too skinny for some to handle, they still maintained long enough to finally include slim, regular, and wide variants, making it more acceptable. And it's been an amazing run for those who have adopted grunge, punk, and even normcore styles. It also benefits from the vintage resurgence that we're still in, and have made patchwork variants more popular as well. Distressed denim made the decade and came out even better once we refined it. And again, it's all in good fun. It's all about you. But the great thing about trends is that some people can find new inspiration or discover a style that fits their lifestyle even more. And once they stick with that style and refine that style, they become even more sure of themselves in the style department. So you don't have to scoff at trends. Use them to explore and to learn. Just don't commit to something because it's a trend or it's popular. Wear what you want, but wear it well. And if you discover something new, there's not a problem picking it up. In any case, let us know some other trends that made the 2010s that didn't make the list, or tell us what you think of these. Or if a trend became a classic, give a thumbs up if you like the video. Follow on Instagram to stay updated on the latest from Japan and beyond. But most importantly, keep it locked right here for all of your info on international street fashion and culture. From Tokyo, it's your boy, and keep it casual. Yoroshiku onegaishimasu. And I'll see you guys in a minute. There you go. I think that's like the confusing thing about trends. It's like when you say something like when you say something fell off, right? It sounds like it's not stylish anymore, but really it's just that it's not in the mainstream anymore. That's kind of like what we mean by something fell off or something became a trend, because most of the time when something becomes a trend, it's already out there. It's just hitting the mainstream in a wave, right? It's already out there, right? Like dad hats have been around forever and then they became hot. Right? Now they're kind of like a staple, right? So that's what we mean by that. So wear what you want, wear it well, but a trend doesn't mean, just because you engage with something that's no longer a trend doesn't mean that you're fashion forward. It just means that you don't care. So don't get confused with the two. That's all I have to say about that.